from Hawaii. Martina Wing here, back with talking about the manta rays. And you see, today I have two manta rays. And today is about making these little mantas and about from the big wig mantas. So, welcome. Hello, Tara is here. Welcome, Tara, my best friend, my super fan. I love it. Thank you for being here. So yeah, here's Martina Wing. I am in Hawaii, and I want to talk about reproduction of the manta rays, how we make the little mantas. No, how they make the little mantas. And I'm going live every Wednesday at 11 a.m. And I'm happy when you join. So give me a thumbs up and a share and all these things. Then I know that I reach the people that I want to talk to. All the manta lovers unite. So reproduction. I want to go through the different stages. And first you see me on camera and I'm talking a little bit. And then I turn the camera around and I have super cool footage prepared and imagery that I think you would really enjoy. And you will learn a lot today. It's really, really cool. Just to let you know, for everybody who hasn't joined before, where am I located? I live on the Big Island of Hawaii. This is our Big Island of Hawaii. And I'm blessed to be with the manta rays for over 20 years. And I dive with them, I research them, I educate about them, I just love to talk about it. And you know, watch out, when you push a button on me, like talk about manta rays, I usually don't stop talking. But it's my true love, I have a very purpose-driven life and I love to share my knowledge about the manta rays. So, and when we talk about manta rays, to see manta rays here on the Kona coast, we are here on the west coast of the island and there are two locations. I live in Kailua Kona. There are two locations where we see the manta ray on a very regular basis. And that's where I got all my footage over the years, my husband and myself. And we have people working with us for a long time with all the cameras out there every night. All right, let's get back. Let's dive right into this manta reproduction. I want to start out with showing you Vicky Ray. This is one of our biggest females. And actually, when you look at the belly, you can actually Frank did this as a good friend of mine. He marked the manta ray with the correct markings for Vicky Ray. So this is Vicky Ray. She's today probably 14, 15 feet, but we met her in, I think, 2002, 2003 with a wingspan of 6 feet. So we've seen her growing up over the years, and she's going to be a part of this footage-wise and also with pictures. So about the manta ray reproduction, when we talk about a manta ray baby, it's actually called a pup, and I'm using a smaller pup for that. So a manta ray is a pup. It took Vicky about then 15 years to be mature enough to have a little pup. And so we say manta rays are mature enough at about teenage age, 15 years and plus. So then they don't reproduce when they're only 5 to 10 years old. We believe in a teenage years. How long do they carry? So here's that's a really cool number, 13 months. Manta rays carry this pup 13 months inside them. And then how often do they have manta rays? The pups are coming every 2 or 3 years. If everything works out, if it's a mature mature female, every 2 or 3 years we see them pregnant. And I, for example, have seen Big Bertha 6 or 7 times over the years, always with a big belly. And I show you the big belly here in a few minutes. Then how many manta rays are born? Actually, only one at a time, that's what we believe. And it has mostly to do with the size of a pup when it's born. And believe it or not, first of all, I want to show you how it looks like when a manta pup is born. It actually comes out of mom and it has its live birth. It has these wings around its body. And I always go really scientific with my terms. That's kind of my specialty. We call this a manta burrito. Okay, so very scientific. So a manta burrito would be the manta ray has, the pup is inside mom. It's here in the back, right here in this area. And so it sits inside and it grows on the inside. It's an egg that hatches in the inside and then it's live birth. So when the pup comes out, it's going to be expelled and then it unrolls its wings and then it starts swimming and then it starts swimming for the rest of its life with perpetual motion. So this is a creature of perpetual motion. Never lays down, never stops swimming. All right. So, and why is it one pup at a time? Well, when the pup comes out and the wingspan, we have seen really, really young ones. And they were only maybe 3 feet. So we believe the pups are about 3 feet wide. And we cannot believe that two pups of that size would be inside mom for the gestation period of 13 months. So now this is the first part of this Facebook Live where I talk about all these facts and numbers and stuff like this. But I want you to know that this is actually a species that is very vulnerable when you think of like 13 months gestation period, every 2 or 3 years. It takes 15 years to be mature enough. And then, actually there are fisheries around the world that hunt manta rays. I don't want to go into this too much right now, but this is definitely a species we have to be really, really careful if we want to keep these guys alive for a long, long time. And I mean, they live millions of years as a species, and their lifespan is 40 to 80 years. So, you know, it's just this is just such a beautiful animal that we want to protect. This was just sidetracking. I want to go back now to the reproduction and switch the camera so you can see some footage and I can show you a little more on that end. So bear with me. I'm going to turn the camera around now. There we go. And you see how I just want to start out with showing you the gender. So if you look at this manta ray, this is a female manta ray. What you look for is the two pelvic fins right here, and that's where the tail comes out. So this would be a female manta ray. Now, male manta ray would be, additionally, here by the tail, it has actually claspers. So at this point, you know the difference between the female and the male. Now, this male is actually a grown-up male. The claspers are maybe the size of my index finger and my middle finger. So, but I do want to mention that when a pup is born, the male parts are really small. And it has happened when we named the manta rays that they have, that we gave them a female name because we couldn't see the claspers. But we fixed that really fast with the name. We didn't fix the male, we just fixed the name, of course. So that has happened two times in the times of naming the manta rays. Anyway, so now you know boys and girls. Now I want to go into how do the males follow the female. And I have some really cool footage here of Big Bertha. Check this out. So the big one is here is the female. It's Big Bertha. And Miles, that's the male, he is right on her, following them very closely. And just the pheromones that the female excretes, and then the male just knows it's time to do this. This is really nice close-up. Ryan shot this a few years ago. I'm so happy to have this footage on file. Check out this. There's Bertha in the front, and then there is Miles right behind her. And so this is how it looks like when the male follows the female. And then I want to go into the next clip where I want to show you where we had a manta train. So we call a manta train when you have many males following a female. I want to jump to about 46 seconds here in the video, and then you can enjoy some footage. So here we go. So we had 46 seconds. So check this out. This is one male, there's another one. Now, this dive was one of the most intense dives for me. It was like 30 manta rays totals at the side, and 15 of them were males just chasing or just going in the manta train trying to follow the female. And Big Bertha was at this phase pregnant. It was just so crazy. It's awesome. Yeah, so like this is, for example, lightning up here. This is Timbuktu. You know, all the males we see all the time. Sugar Ray is going to be here in the mix. Cousteau Ray was still around. Really, really cool stuff. And there is a myth out there. I want to do a little myth busting that it says that manta rays, that the female is impregnated by just one male, the strongest stays, but actually that's not true. We've recorded Miles Ray, like we saw earlier in the footage, that was with Big Bertha during the day, and then about 4 days later they had moved down the coast 20 miles. We filmed them again. Miles was still the single male on Big Bertha. And then guess what? 7 days later, lightning was on Big Bertha. And so another single male was on her tail. And that just shows that we really don't know who's the father, who's the daddy. It could be so multiple, I guess. But cool. So this is the footage about manta trains. I think that it's really insane to see all these males coming through the dive site. That was really, really cool. Alrighty, so, and then when it gets really hot, I have some footage for you guys via Vicky Ray. So a little skip forward here. So you have to concentrate a little bit on the fast moving mantas in the background. And here in this case, we have Vicky Ray, the manta ray I showed you at the beginning. Vicky Ray is really, really being chased down by Timbuktu. And here they're coming out of the back. I'm not gonna let this play this footage. It's really, really cool to see. Now, the night experience with the manta rays is actually about feeding, right? We turn on the lights and the mantas are coming to feed. Now, Gina is here. Hello, this is nice. Thank you. So back to chasing here. Vicky Ray is in the front, Timbuktu behind. Sugar Ray is a little confused. He kind of lost track. He didn't know where to go anymore. That was really cool too, to see. But they can definitely multitask. They're actually feeding or they're trying to feed. Vicky, is trying to feed. He is getting really hot. Check this out right in front of the camera. So awesome. But they're getting distracted by all the mating courtship craziness. Yeah, I'm going to give you this close-up one more time because it's so cool. Right in front of the camera, you can see his claspers trying to, yeah, get really, really close and do the actual act. I'm sorry I don't have the actual act, but I think you can maybe imagine it how it is when the claspers do their thing. Yeah, that's all I'm going to say about this. So, alrighty. So this is what I want to show you when it goes really crazy with the manta rays, when they're being chased down by the boys. And then what's next? I wanted to show you then how it looks like when the manta ray is actually pregnant and how the belly looks like. Now for that, I'm going to go to these pictures. And I have three different manta rays pregnant where we point out where to look for, Now this is Andrea Ray and this is my friend Tara. And you can see actually how the belly is extended in this part of their body. And remember I talked about the manta burrito. And so the manta burrito is just growing inside mom right here. This is, for example, Andrea Ray. We also have Vicky Ray. Check out this angle. It's really clear to us that this is a pup growing inside her. And then, of course, our queen. This is Big Bertha. And I think she's 12 months into this. And just to remind you, it's 13 months gestation period. And it's going to be live birth. I'm going to have some pictures of that. Oh, well, just pictures and storytelling. It's never been really recorded. I take that back too. It's been in Okinawa Aquarium recorded, but it's really hard to find footage online right now. But I'm going to search for you and you can check out the description later on for all kinds of cool reference videos if you want to. All right, so this is how what we look for. And now I prepared another video where you can actually see the different stages. I have four different stages where Big Bertha is being pregnant. So let's stop right here. Just want to point out real quick that this is October 24, 2010. And if you look at the timeline, the very beginning footage I showed you where Miles was chasing Big Bertha was filmed in May. So we are 6 months later in October. And no, 5 months later, October 24th. And then at that point, we thought Big Bertha could be pregnant. So we just look for these signs if Big Bertha has a big belly. Look at this bigger belly. And we were not sure, but we thought so. Now we skip another, this would be now March 8, 2011. So this would be 10 months after it. And you know, it's really getting to the point where we see this belly is really, really obvious. And with the whole story to be 13 months pregnant, now check out this one, we are on June 8th. So Big Bertha was chased by Miles and Lightning and by other manta rays on a year before, 12 months prior to this, May, June. And so it's all true about 13 months gestation period. I was then really, really, our whole team was really excited about seeing how much longer Big Bertha is carrying this baby. So let's keep playing this. So the belly is getting bigger and bigger for sure. So this is June 8th. And we are just so lucky we see her so many times to actually be able to put this in sequence. Now we're on June 30th. It's about 28 days later, 18, whatever, a few days later. Big, big belly. I want to show you this big belly one more time. Just really round, big belly. And guess what? 14 days later, we are on July 15th. Big Bertha's at the dive site and her belly is flat. We were so stoked. I was screaming underwater. If you see hear the audio behind this clip, I was just so stoked that Big Bertha was, you know, just just not pregnant anymore, and that meant we were supposed to see a pup manta ray sometime soon. All right, so these are the scenes of Big Bertha's timeline in the stages. I actually have a whole pregnancy diary made of this video, and again, look, check in the description for the link to watch the whole video. All right, and now the baby birth, born, it's born, and then we have many pictures of little mantas, but I wanted to show you something really cool, and these pictures were taken by Roberta Fabri, and we have permission for educational purposes to use these pictures. Now check this out, where you see the full dilation of the pup being born. So here's full dilation. And then, don't you think this is a manta burrito? I'm totally convinced that this is a manta burrito at this point. So live birth is expelled by mom. The little one comes out. And then check out the last one. It is, a little manta on the reef. And what we know is that the manta, when it's pushed out, it just sinks until it's unrolled its wings. And as soon as it unrolls its wings, then it starts swimming. I repeat myself now, but it's then manta ray is then in perpetual motion for the rest of its life and just keeps swimming for 40 to 80 years. Cool, cool, cool stuff. Alrighty, so thank you, Roberto, for taking these pictures. I want to swing back to my face. See there. Connie, you're here too. I can see that. Thank you so much for being here. Alrighty, so this was all about manta ray pregnancy, manta burritos, and the numbers that come with it, and really explaining also that this is a vulnerable species. And in another Facebook Live, I will talk about what's happening around the globe and what we can do, and that manta rays stay protected, and what you can do as well. But I think this is enough for today. Long video. Let me look at the watch. Yep, I'm about 17 minutes in. So I think that's plenty of talking and showing you stuff when I don't want to hold you up much longer. But be ready for more Facebook Lives. I actually want to change a little bit my subject matter to be more of a critical voice. Talk about the manta experience here in town and the overcapacity problems we have in Kona. And I do want to give you some information about that. So let's see what I'm going to do next week. I haven't decided yet, but I'm going to shift a little bit for manta ray education and about the species itself and all the things I know to more of a critical voice, and also what, as a vulnerable species, the manta rays have to endure these days around the planet, and also what you can do to make their life better. All right, so if you liked what I did today, please give me a like, give me a share, comment. If you commented already, I can't see it. I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong on that part, but I will answer your comments later today for sure. Give me a share if this is something you enjoy, and I see you again next week on Wednesday, 11 a.m. from Hawaii. Martina Wing here. Talk to you later. Bye bye.